Welcome back to Forza Horizon 4, guys. Today's video is gonna be a little bit different than my regular types of videos because today we're gonna be talking about Forza Horizon 5. Ever since this thing, the Xbox Series X, was officially revealed to the world, you guys have had thousands upon thousands of questions regarding the future of Forza Motorsport, as well as Forza Horizon 5. Now, before we get into any of this, I always need to start these videos up with a little disclaimer. No, Forza Horizon 5 is not confirmed in any way. When it does officially get confirmed, you will definitely be hearing it here on the channel first, so make sure you subscribe if you want to stay up to date with everything Forza Horizon 5 related. But what we're gonna be doing today is taking what we know about the Xbox Series X, Forza Motorsport, and Forza Horizon 4 to give us a very good idea of what Forza Horizon 5 could look like. If we're gonna do that, to get a better idea of what we're talking about, we need to rewind the clocks a couple of months to the Xbox Series X reveal, and more importantly, the new Forza Motorsport game reveal, also known as Forza Motorsport 8, kinda. I've already actually gone in and made an entire video on the new Forza Motorsport game where we dissected the trailer, spoke about a bunch of the features coming to the game. If you haven't checked out that video, it's a super cool one. I will link to it in the description down below. I highly suggest you check it out after this one. However, for today's purposes, there are two big things in that trailer that are important to us. One, there was no release date given for the next Forza Motorsport game, and two, it will not be available on the Xbox One. What that tells us is the earliest Forza Motorsport will be coming out is late 2021 or even possibly 2022. And that's also gonna affect the release date of Forza Horizon 5. Currently, all of these release dates are up in the air right now. We have no idea what's going on. It's possible even Forza Horizon 5 might take the 2021 release date or move all the way back to 2022. Regardless, it's gonna be either 3 years or possibly even 4 years of development between Forza Horizon 4 and Forza Horizon 5, which is insane. There have even been rumors about a third expansion for Forza Horizon 4 to tide people over until the next Forza game's release. That's a question for another day though. We will come back to that in a future video. And this release date affects everything about the next Forza Horizon game. Usually, Forza only has 2 years between Forza Horizon releases to work on their game. If they're taking 3 or even 4 years to work on the next Forza Horizon game, our expectations are bigger than ever. It changes everything that we've spoken about so far. With that being said, today, I wanted to take into account that extra time. Talk about things like the location, the cars, the story, the customization, the game modes, and much more. So let's jump into this. Let's start it off with the biggest thing of them all, the location itself. This affects the entire way the game works, the atmosphere, the story, the cars you toss in, and much more. So the location is number one. Don't worry, I can already see you jumping out of your chair going, Japan! I want Japan! I don't really want to get too far into Japan because I feel like everybody has already spoken about it so much, just like with the map itself, with all of these crazy twisty roads, the mountains, including the off-roading, the coastal roads, and everything like that. It presents a lot of opportunities, but if they're gonna do Japan, since it's so requested, Forza has to absolutely nail it. And if they've got 3 or 4 years to work on their game, they might be able to do it. As cool as Japan is, I could talk about it all day. I do want to talk about some of the other locations where I would love to see a Forza Horizon game take place. For example, where I'm from in Canada. Canada would actually be a super cool place to have a Forza game. We have some of the best landscapes in the entire world. We already have all four seasons and you don't need to fake snow in the UK. Canada is actually filled with densely packed cities as well as these huge open landscapes for you to go and explore as well. As cool as Canada is for me, and I'm sure a bunch of you guys as well, there have been murmurs about plenty of other places. For example, also Dubai. Dubai is an awesome place with massive cities and huge deserts for people to go and explore. However, I feel like just doesn't have the diversity that a Forza Horizon game needs. As much as I think we can all agree we hate the trees in Forza Horizon games, we kind of need them to make it feel fun to drive around. And I feel like that's something we may not necessarily get enough of with a place like Dubai. That's enough discussion about the location. I feel like I could talk about it all day. Let's move it on to the thing that this game is known for, the cars themselves. And again, I could list cars for days. That's not what I'm gonna do here, though. I wanted to mention two things in particular. One, diversity within the car lineup. We need a car for everybody in this game to go, I love that car, I wanna buy that car. Whether you're a fan of the latest and greatest supercars and hypercars, your favorite SUVs and trucks, classic muscle cars, JDM cars, European cars, or even the buggies that we've been driving around, we need something for everybody. Forza's done a really good job of this in the past, so I just hope to see some more of it in the next game. With 4 years between the games, who knows what we could see. Number two, I would also love to see more unique cars, more special cars, like things from the past, like the Halo Warthog, the Quartz Regalia, or the Rocket 69. They may not be the most realistic thing, but in terms of a sheer fun factor and feeling fresh for a game like this, they are the best thing out there. Not to mention Forza Edition cars. They might seem a bit boring off the start, but if they got rolled into the game slowly throughout its lifespan, I guarantee we would all be jumping into them. Gran Turismo actually does these unique cars very, very well. They had a goddamn moon buggy in their game. It doesn't get much more special than that. Or, for example, this thing, the Red Bull X2014, one of the fastest cars ever made. Well, ever made, kind of. Now, what about the customization of those cars? I know I've already spoken about, like, window painting before, decals, wide bodies, exhausts, and all those types of things. Today, I wanted to talk about two things that are confirmed as coming to Forza Motorsport that could very well find their way into Forza Horizon in the near future. One, Forza Motorsport is implementing a brand new suspension model. In terms of Forza Motorsport, that probably means more realistic physics when you're going around some famous corners on some famous racetracks. In terms of Forza Horizon, though, a new suspension model could mean the ability to do things that we never could before, like lifting up your car and putting huge tires on it, like monster truck style tires, for example, or being able to slam your car right to the ground where it's scraping the ground everywhere you go. Or maybe even air suspension. Who knows what the limits of this new suspension model is? The second thing that we know that's coming to the next Forza Motorsport game is exhaust, if you swap them on your car, will change the sound of your car. Say, for example, you swap on a huge fart cannon exhaust onto your car, you will now get that huge fart cannon exhaust sound. I would hope to see that feature come to Forza Horizon as well, along with the ability of getting more exhaust options. For example, being able to swap a fart cannon exhaust onto your car, or like burnt titanium tips type of stuff. Things that you see on real life cars. Being able to do that in the game, always a good thing. Now, here's the thing. With 3 to 4 years to work on the next Forza game, I am expecting something bigger and better than we have ever got before. And that leads me into the next point, which is a story mode. I've actually been playing a lot of older car games here on the channel recently, and one thing they all seem to have in common is a really, really good story. Take Driver San Francisco, for example. Whatever happened to the idea of a Horizon boss or Darius Flint, for example? Honestly, if you ask me personally, if you go through an entire game and at the end of it, you don't hate one of the characters, it wasn't a very good story. And no, before you say it, Anna doesn't count as a character. As much as I hate her and I turn her off all the time, she doesn't count. I don't want to talk about Anna anymore. We've got to move it on to the last thing. Let's talk about the game modes. For Forza Horizon 4, they actually added in some new game modes. For example, things like the Eliminator, one of my most favorite things to do when I'm just playing this game for fun. But with 3 to 4 years to get the next game out, oh, who knows what we could see. Cops and Robbers game modes would be super cool. Toss me in some more freeze tag games. Like I've said, the common trend throughout this video, I am expecting something bigger and better than we have ever seen before. I think this video is long enough though. I hope you guys enjoyed it. That is what I am looking forward to for Forza Horizon 5, and hopefully gives you guys some ideas of things that you would like to see in this game. So let me know in the comments down below, and who knows, there's going to be a lot of time before the next game. Maybe we'll do another one of these. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys at some point in the future for some more Forza Horizon 4 news. I'll see you guys then. Bye!